you feel a kind of weight of expectation? I mean, this is your 15th album. You've got this fan base who will ascribe meaning to you that you haven't put there, and they're waiting for everything you say. Is that kind of inhibiting in the studio when you're writing stuff, or can you just forget about the pressure?
I can forget about it when I'm writing and when we're recording. It's the rest of the time. It's reading reviews and find a review that's been written in the past 15 or 20 years that doesn't bring our entire back catalog into it, and I'll give you £10.
Yeah.
It's really hard to be up against yourself.
Well, I don't think you've ever released an album that hasn't been reviewed as being a return to form. Like you're constantly just returning to form, which implies that they've actually all been on form.
Thank you for that.
But that's the implication of that, isn't it? But people always want to sort of feel like there's a measure somewhere, a hurdle you have to get over.
Well, people have the thing about music as a powerful medium is that people are able to listen to stuff and acknowledge what is being given to them, what people often don't realize, and I speak of myself as well as any music fan, is that what music meant to you at a certain time in your life, you don't bring yourself into the equation. So we all tend to forget that we're getting older, and that music as a 17, 18, 23, 25, 28-year-old had a very different place in our lives than it might as a 35, 40, 51-year-old.
Yeah.
Right? So that makes my job a little more difficult, because what I do when I do what I do best is hold up a mirror to you, and you reflect yourself in my work, and that makes it, as a medium, the most powerful, the most personal, the thing that will be with you for the rest of your life, hopefully.
But when you're starting out, so you're putting your first tracks down and you're just in the really early days, you can't be looking forward and thinking, one day we'll be in that position. At some point, you're just going in thinking, let's have fun.
You mean way back?
And this, And this album sounds like you're having fun.
We are having fun.
And that feels really fresh and young in that way.
The band are at a great place personally and as collaborators. And collaboration is, compromise is inherent within a band, where it's not with a solo artist. And so, or with someone who's kind of running a show, you know, running their own thing, like, I don't know, Lady Gaga or Beyonce or someone. The thing about REM is that, you know, you can kind of tell when we're in good moods with each other and when we're not. We're in a really good mood with each other right now. And so that's great.
There has to be a relationship between band members that I think it's hard for people from the outside to understand, because you're sort of friends and you're colleagues, but it's not work. It's a different environment.
But it is work.
Exactly. But it also, you're sort of bonded together for life.
You
can never not be REM.
For better and for worse.
Yeah.
Well, that leads to something that I always say, and I always like to say it, which is that we always made our own choices, and we took advice, but we never put other people's advice over our own ideas of what was best. With that come all the triumphs and all the high points of a 30-year career. With that also come the failures and the times that we fell on our face. But we own that. Like, it's kind of, there's a certain liberation to knowing that even the failure is something that I own. And I can say, we didn't do our best there, but look at this.
Yeah. I think, but there's always a kind of, if you can say we didn't do our best, you know what? We were trying to do our best. And we were experimenting with something, we were playing with something, then there's dignity and honor in that. It's when you're not trying that's an issue.
We never phoned it in.
Yeah.
Not once.